So let's have a quick overview first and get the technical part of the pipeline out of the way. Luckily for us, Blender, Painter, and Unity all use MCTSpace. So in this case, we can choose whether we want to include the tangent and bitangent upon export. If we include them, they will simply be explicit numbers in the file, which is the exact same that Painter and Unity will create as well. But let's just include them in case we use the model in a pipeline which does not use MCT at a later time. We can then import the tangents from the file and the normal map will work for us still. But even though they all use MCT, that does not mean that the internal triangulation of the model is the same between the different softwares. MCT is sensitive to the triangulation, so if it changes, we will get shading errors based on the normal map that is applied. So we will still have to triangulate our low poly model. So here we are in Blender. We have the low poly, which is the target model of the baked textures. And we need to make sure that all the objects has the triangulate modifier attached to it. We can triangulate the model ourselves with Ctrl T, but if we have the modifier attached to it, then we don't have to use the trist to quad function every time we want to make some changes to it later. We can also have a look at the UVs. Are there any overlapping UVs of objects that share the same material? If there are overlappings, we need to correct this now by selecting all the objects which share this particular material by pressing Shift L and choose Select Linked Material and perform the basic packing operations afterwards. So go into edit mode, go to UVs in the UV editor, add Pack Islands, Average Island Scale, and Minimize Stretch to your quick favorites menu and save your preferences if you have not done so already. You will be constantly using them after all. And access and perform them by pressing Q. Also, are the models unwrapped in a way that avoids creating diagonal lines in the UV editor, such as from cylinders? By avoiding diagonal lines, the texels become much less apparent in the bake. So now that we are sure that the UVs are correct and the object has been assigned the triangulate modifier, we can export the low poly model. In the export settings, there are three settings worth noting here. We need to make sure we only export the selected objects out of here. If not, we will export everything in the project, even those that are hidden from view. Next, we need to make sure the apply modifier is checked. This is so the triangulate modifiers are applied to the low poly and so on. Finally, we need to decide whether to include the tangents or not. As mentioned in the overview, Blender, Painter, and Unity all use MCT, so we could theoretically export it without the tangents because they will be generated the same way as Blender anyways. But we might as well include it so we can place the model in an archive and have it ready to be used in conjunction with other pipelines later on. We can then simply import the tangents to the program which does not use MCT. So now we are on to the high poly. There's not much to go over here really. If the model looks good in the viewport now, it should look good for the baker as well. We just need to make sure the apply modifiers is checked in the export settings so that the subdivision surface modifier is applied. So let's go over some of the basic mishaps of the cage model. Every time we make the duplication of the low poly to create the foundation for the cage model, we need to apply the triangulation modifier immediately. If we start moving vertices around, it will be triangulated differently from the low poly target model upon export. So if the triangulation is different from the low poly target model, the cage will result in a bad bake. This also means that if we have moved any vertices on the low poly in a manner which could result in an eternal triangulation flip, the cage model needs to be done again as well. And if the UV layout is different from the low poly target model, the cage will again result in a bad bake. So if we have made any changes to the UV layout on the low poly model, we need to redo the cage model again as well. So if we are absolutely sure that it will have the same triangulation and UV layout, we can then export it. This time we include the tangents again, just to make sure the tangents are the same between the low poly and the cage model, no matter what tangent space the baker is using. Now that we have exported the low poly, high poly, and cage model, we can move on to Painter. As we start a new project in Painter, we are faced with these options. We can choose the Unity 5 template from here, and all that will do for us is to switch the normal map format to OpenGL. And this is fine, but a compute tangent space per fragment is still unchecked. I've been running some tests on my end, and I'm pretty sure that the documentation which states that this is only relative to the Unreal Engine is outdated at this point. The documentation was written before Unity switched to MCT. But in my tests, the lines suffer from less bendings, and overall the flatter surfaces look flatter when baked with this on in shaders which uses MCT, be it in Unity, Blender, or Toolbag. So, since we are using MCT in Unity, we are going to enable this button. The difference in a normal map is not much, but it matters. So let's bake the mesh maps. We turn off all the maps now besides the normal map because we just want to check for projection errors at this stage. If we have properly named the objects in Blender, like lamp foot low and lamp foot high, we want to enable match by mesh name to avoid the surface of lamp arm high to project onto the lamp foot low surface, for instance. Perform the bake, and if something is wrong, we need to go back to the checklist. It does not matter if the model is triangulated at this point because it is baked to the internal triangulation anyways, so we cannot identify this error at this stage. But if we've used a cage model, is the cage identical in triangulation and UV layout to the low poly? And if it is, are we sure that the cage model has been extended to fully overlap the high poly model? And if not, it cannot see the high poly geometry. So if all these are correct, it might be that we have exported too few or too many objects in our file. So we can go back to Blender and make sure we have selected all the high poly objects and re-export it. And if we have used the match by mesh name, we need to make sure we have actually named the objects correctly. When we are sure of this list, the baking should work out fine. Now we just need to enable the rest of the maps and bake it out. So when we are done texturing the model in Painter, we can just export the maps using the Unity 5 preset from the export textures settings. And in Unity 5, we will just drag in the maps here and the files and drag it into the scene. Unity defaults the tangent space to MCT, so we don't need to worry about the tangent space for our imported models. Should we want to change it for whatever reason later on, we can find the settings by selecting the meshes in the file directory and changing the tangents in the inspector. But if we are having problems with the normal maps in this stage, we can go over another checklist. Was the low poly triangulated in Blender upon export? Because if Painter and Unity triangulates the model differently, then the normal map will be applied to angles it was not originally baked for. So go back to Blender and make sure it was triangulated either by us or by a modifier upon export. Also, is the normal map baked with the green channel in the correct direction. The reason we get the opportunity to select between OpenGL and DirectX in Painter is because the two computer graphics frameworks use the Y coordinate oppositely, or the tangent. So if a pixel has a value 74 in the green channel, it points upwards or downwards depending on which framework we are using. So if the normal map looks bad at this point, it is probably because the green channel needs to be flipped. This should cover most of the hurdles in the pipeline, but many minor things can go wrong. But if the normal map is not applied correctly to the meshes in Unity or Toolbag, for instance, it is most likely a difference in the tangent space, so keep in mind what data is passed and how it is referenced between the programs.